Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Karen Ashford, and I have the distinct pleasure of being your MC this afternoon. Nadlugana, Nadlutupandi, Yatanga Tikandi. I acknowledge the traditional owners of the Kaurna lands upon which we are holding this event today, and I pay my respects to their elders, past, present and emerging. I also acknowledge their unbroken connection to country. I'd like to extend our acknowledgement to the elders of all the lands upon which Flinders University teaches and reaches. Before we embark on the celebrations, a few housekeeping rules, because we all have them, don't we? We trust today's ceremony will be seamless, but should we need to exit the building, please follow the marked exit signs to the side and the rear of the hall. Should you require them, you'll find comfort facilities in the foyer. Shortly, the academic procession will enter and the Australian National Anthem will be sung. That'll be followed by speeches. At the conclusion of the first round of speeches, we will collect the graduates from their seats, one row at a time, to come up to the side of the stage to line up for presentation. Graduates, please follow the instructions of our staff as you make your way onto the stage. As you have your name called out, please note the tassel on your hat goes on the left-hand side. It's actually really important you get that in the right spot because you want your photo to be fantastic. As you come across the stage, you'll stand next to the Chancellor for the photo. There'll be three flashes, so don't run off before you get your full of photos. And then you'll exit the stage to the left and our staff will guide you back to your allocated seat. Our university's namesake, the great navigator, Captain Matthew Flinders, is remembered not just as an explorer, but as a man obsessed by the pursuit of knowledge. Together with Bungaree, a Kuringai man who acted as his interpreter and guide, Flinders was noted for his fearlessness and his determination that his actions would speak to the world. It's in that tradition that we, as a strong and distinctive university, continue to expand human knowledge and make a positive difference in society as an innovative and collaborative place to learn, research, and thrive.
Flinders University was founded in an era of profound social, political, and technological change. A product of these times, we have always been ready to step away from the security of the familiar and forge new ways forward. This appetite for exploration is ingrained in our DNA. It's shaped our world-class curriculum and the physical and online environments we live, learn, and work in, enabling new connections between academics, students, and industry. Brave research is the beating heart of our university, the purest expression of our desire to discover and our ability to solve. Ours is an inclusive culture that transcends borders and backgrounds. We believe absolutely in equality and opportunity for all. We work to serve our communities and empower our people, giving rise to healthier societies and empathic leaders. Our legacy, our values, our vision has never mattered more than it does right now. We don't just survive in challenging times, we thrive in them. We don't resist change or fear disruption, we embrace it, work with it. We adapt and evolve, we discover, we create, we share. We are Flinders, we are fearless.
I now invite you to stand for the academic procession and to please remain standing for the Australian National Anthem, sung this afternoon by Jess Bigg. Thank you.
Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are one and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil, our home is girt by sea. A land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty.
Please be seated.
Kāna mihi nei wangani, mani te puni gāri atana. Nei bira kō, mankalakala tandanya mianaku. Nei te yungandalia, nei te yakanandalia, padni adlu wadu. On behalf of the Kāna people, I welcome you all to Kāna country, and I do this ambassador of the Adelaide Plains people. My brothers, my sisters, let's walk together in harmony. Gatalia.
Chancellor Mr. Stephen Gerlach AM, Deputy Vice Chancellor Students Professor Romy Lawson, Vice President and Executive Dean Professor Alison Kitson, Council Member Dr. Amanda Muller, members of university staff, graduates and guests. Flinders University's Chancellor is Mr. Stephen Gerlach AM, a law graduate from the University of Adelaide and an eminent South Australian company director. Mr. Gerlach has been Chancellor of Flinders University since 2010. He was awarded a Member of the Order of Australia for his service to community. I invite Mr. Gerlach to open today's proceedings.
Thank you and good afternoon. Deputy Vice Chancellor Students Professor Romy Lawson, Vice President and Executive Dean of the College of Nursing and Health Sciences Professor Alison Kitson, Council Member Dr. Amanda Muller, members of university staff, graduates and guests. Before we begin, I would like to acknowledge that we are gathered today on the traditional lands of the Kāna people, and we pay our respects to Kāna elders past, present and emerging. On behalf of Flinders University, it is my great honour to welcome you to today's graduation celebration event for the College of Nursing and Health Sciences. To our graduates, today is all about celebrating you and your achievements. Graduation from a university is a milestone achievement and a moment of great pride and joy. We have watched in awe and admiration as you persevered through some of the most difficult years that many of us have ever faced. While we are here to applaud this achievement, I hope you take a moment for yourself to reflect upon and congratulate yourselves for the hard work, determination, and perseverance that has got you here today. You certainly deserve it. Whilst today's ceremony is a chance for us to acknowledge your accomplishments, it is also an opportunity for us to consider the irreplaceable role each and every one of you plays in the legacy of Flinders University. When you venture into the world, you are further evidence of the fact that Flinders University has earned the reputation as the home of enterprising and brilliant graduates. You will join a community of thought leaders, game changers, innovators, and glass ceiling shatterers located around the world who are challenging the status quo and doing great things. The document you receive is not only a symbol of your academic achievement, but also of a personal one that should also be held in high esteem. It is evidence of your knowledge, skills, strength, and dedication, all of which will serve you well as you venture into a constantly evolving world. I have a little doubt that you will all go on to make your own unique mark on the world, not only through your actions and your contributions, but hopefully the kindness and empathy you show to others. I would also like to take a moment to acknowledge the loved ones who have supported you through your journey to reach this milestone. They have been the ones who celebrated all of your wins and commiserated on your losses. And they have been the support you needed as you navigated the path of further study. For those of you here today who did not have such a valuable personal support network, or for those who have faced significant challenges throughout your studies, I would like to extend my sincere commendations. A university degree is by no means a walk in the park, and to complete one without a strong support network shows us that you have a tenacity and strength of character that will help you through all of life's challenges. Whilst I am thanking those who have been a part of our graduates' journeys, I must not forget our talented and committed staff who have inspired and challenged you throughout your studies. Flinders University is incredibly lucky to be home to some of the world's leading teaching experts whose fearless and dedicated approach to teaching underlies that Flinders University is never satisfied with settling, we are never complacent, and we are always striving to do better, to be better, and to achieve more. Today marks the end of the first stage of your journey with Flinders and the start of a new stage as a member of a global community of more than 120,000 alumni who are shaping our future through integrity, courage, innovation, and excellence. You will join Fulbright Scholars, General Sir John Monash Scholars, Rhodes Scholars, South Australian and Australian of the Year, Logies Hall of Fame members, healthcare heroes, literary icons, and sporting superstars, all of whom have called Flinders University home. You will be joining the likes of Felicity Crowther, Executive Director of the South Australian Council on Intellectual Disability, and Peter Jenkin, Nurse Practitioner, Palliative Care, Resthaven, who are working to improve care and ensure that all Australians have and are treated equally. I encourage you to join our alumni network, which will help you stay in contact with the university and with each other. Just as we have been here throughout your education, we would be honoured to be invited to join you as you embark on your next chapter, to celebrate in your achievement, share in your lives, and be a part of whatever you do next. And so goodbye and good luck to you all. We will be watching with interest as you each embark on your next fearless journey. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Gerlach, for overseeing today's proceedings and for your continued contribution as Flinders Chancellor. I now invite Professor Alison Kitson, Vice President and Executive Dean of the College of Nursing and Health Sciences, to present the graduates.
Chancellor. Before I present the graduates of the College of Nursing and Health Sciences, I would just like to acknowledge the wonderful, diverse and international cohort of students who will become graduates. I also want to personally acknowledge the incredible resilience and fearlessness that they have shown over these last 3 years, coping with degrees and COVID at the same time. And I just want to say that if I don't pronounce your names correctly, and even more alarmingly, if your parents don't recognize you as I call you out, please forgive me and I'll do my best. So, Chancellor, Diploma in Disability and Community Practice, Hannah Crichton. Caitlin Pace. Diploma in Health Sciences, Iman G.S. Najib. Associate Degree in Disability and Community Practice, Sophia Samimi. Degree of Bachelor of Disability and Developmental Education, Amelia Denton. Charlotte Guy. Stephanie Hickey. Mustaquam Amar Khan. Tania Mann. Jade Amanda Pash. Degree of Bachelor of Exercise Science, Kelly Sonny Fettis. Degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences, Juliana Chan. Degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences Therapy Studies, Bethan Abbey Ricketts. Degree of Bachelor of Human Nutrition, Joanna R. Ang. Catherine Alice Burns. Shu Mei Lim. Degree of Bachelor of Letters, Health, Shannon Louise Regina. Degree of Bachelor of Midwifery, Sojourn Renshaw. Degree of Bachelor of Nursing, Chinwendu Ahontu. Alberto Il Androy Albit. Anarit Kaur. Vandana Checheri. Lakshmi Awashtri. Gobindur Kaur Bashadwaz. Sabita Vatratai. Zarina Camboranero. Lillian Luhan Khan. Peisham Zhang. Lilin Noin Ding. Elena Voktoronova Esten. Windana Mange Epa. Ashley Jane Fields. Jundi Flores. Anupa Gurung. Gina James. Olivia Jord. Gita Casey Rocca. Bhagwan Kaur. Minsar Kim. Soo-yoon Kim. Rene Lam. Huyu Yin Lee. Ting Him Desmond Lee. Ches Ching Haley Lee. Lily. Wing Yang Yvonne Low. Zhu Yi Ma. Bindu Maharjan. Kan Chan Thakuri. Mm-hmm. Mandeep Kaur. Rowan Francis Mendoza Mercado. Anu Mokhtan. Tamina Naznin. Niha. Nisha Namakul. Usha Namkul. Manjit Kaur Sukhwanching Nizar. Nilima Gautmam. Onzu Paudel Chetri. Suprema Pradhan. Samjana Prajapati. Katrina Quatresma. Ahavna Raut. Rashmita Roka. Imasha Salwatura. Navdeep Sandhu. Zorada de la Cruz Santos. Guyani Senaviri Nate. Amit Sharma. Akiko Shinde. Budisara Sunar. Ruchi Tamang. Winnie So Yi Tan. Min Tran. Rosemary Ningongare Wainana. Dai Wang. Harum Yong. Muna Hun Yan Hemnyan. Degree of Bachelor of Nutrition and Dietetics, Regan Pethrick. Samantha Skye. Degree of Bachelor of Nutrition Science, Clara Shad. Degree of Bachelor of Speech Pathology, Wing Yi Chan. Rongiu Mayalang. Eunice Nyong. Honours degree of Bachelor of Disability and Developmental Education, Patrick Fabian Blessel. Honours degree of Bachelor of Health Sciences, Anushka Jacob. Honours degree of Bachelor of Nursing, Luke Shepherd. Honours degree of Bachelor of Nutrition and Dietetics, Katie Wooldridge. Honours degree of Bachelor of Speech Pathology, Chi Lok Mok. Jacinta Sir Chi An Yi. Graduate Certificate in Acute Care Nursing, Pabrita Gautam. Donalyn Sankey. Graduate Certificate in Acute Care Nursing, Critical Care, Shiny George. Yvonne Eunice Apio Kangwa. Nope. Sorry, not here. Annalie Lehman. Graduate Certificate in Acute Care Nursing Emergency, Sharni Kaur. Graduate Certificate in Disability Studies, Shay Martin. Kerry Tsinsin Neotis. Graduate Certificate in Palliative Care, Jenna Diana Muscat. Folasada Obagami. Graduate Certificate in Positive Behaviour Support, Conchita Larissa. Graduate Diploma in Applied Gerontology, Harman Deep Danat Sad. Kathleen Dumas. Graduate Diploma in Clinical Rehabilitation, Amy Williamson. Graduate Diploma in Nursing, Child and Family Health, Eliza Marsland. Graduate Diploma in Nursing, Emergency, Catherine Davidson-Tare. Graduate Diploma in Nursing Mental Health and also for the Bachelor of Nursing, Kishore Daki. Aye. Georgina Ann Jones. Navdeep Kaur. Nina Malala. Shikithi Malangna. Graduate Diploma in Palliative Care, Andrea Rivers Thompson. Suzanne Tucker. Degree of Bachelor of Medical Science, Vision Science, Master of Optometry, Aileen Akam. Bill Duo Ng. David Lee. Hui Nogoyen. Demi Kate O'Brien. Mark Petherbridge. Alea Rahimi. Reshehen Tulkanum. Degree of Master of Audiology, Kaji Ahmad. Onathani Anthony Jenkanathan. Elena Jaibi. Hefsibah Simon. Isaiah Nunnerly. Lia Elizabeth Shaju. Degree of Master of Clinical Rehabilitation, Debbie Zonneveld. Degree of Master of Clinical Rehabilitation, Neurological Physiotherapy, Gabrielle Hill. Degree of Master of Disability Policy and Practice, Sophie Leanne Georgianakis. Degree of Master of Nurse Practitioner, Bernadette Crosby. Jaskaran Singh Dhaliwal. Catherine Elizabeth Fernside. Nicola Hamoud. Cara McLean. Paula Moran. Degree of Master of Nursing Acute Care, Huju Angela Jung. Degree of Master of Nursing Aged Care, Sangeeta Buntai-Hockey. Jita Kadka. Degree of Master of Nursing Coursework and Research, James Grimmett. And Sagan Hagos. Patraporn Kunmi. Runjuna Punape. Petraya Zela Savrova. Degree of Master of Nursing Critical Care, Laura Corchi. Ella Nobbs. Degree of Master of Nursing, Diabetes Management and Education, Stella Florence Zambi. Mami Sun. Degree of Master of Nursing Emergency, Edward Matto. Degree of Master of Nursing Mental Health, Fung E. Lore. Ramampret Danwawa. Rumi Shakwa. Simba Simbanda. Degree of Master of Nutrition and Dietetics, Ying K. Bonkan. Prithika Nayar. Degree of Master of Palliative Care, Kate Chesworth. Emily Kate Hewitt. Francesca Cuoma. Rose Maundo. Anita Thapa. Degree of Master of Physiotherapy, Chelsea Simone Cook. Taylor McMillan. Andrew Mitchell. Lena Pham. Degree of Master of Speech Pathology, Huang Ang Lai. Ming Yang Li. Matthew Lycos. Muzamil Wakar. Degrees of Bachelor of Health Sciences and Master of Occupational Therapy, Jordan Iovino. Ruby Mason. Shreten Radusen. Degrees of Bachelor of Health Sciences and Master of Physiotherapy, Torley Lee Keisler. A doctorate demonstrates a significant achievement in both scholarly research and professional development. The next graduates to be presented have made original contributions to knowledge that benefit academia, industry, the environment, and our society. This research and these researchers will enable the transformation of knowledge. Graduate theses citations are printed in the graduation books. So, Chancellor, I now present the graduates for the Doctor of Philosophy. Nicola Baker, by thesis entitled Postural Sway in Near Fallers, Effects of Fatigue and Distraction. I present Dr. Nikki Baker. Julie Melissa Brose. Now, Julie has actually also received the Vice Chancellor's Award for Doctoral Thesis Excellence. By thesis entitled The Intentional Pursuit of Everyday Life While Dying, a Longitudinal Exploration of Occupational Engagement for Working Aged Adults Living with Advanced Cancer. I present Dr. Julie Melissa Brose. Jenny Louise Cleland. By thesis entitled Developing the Descriptive System for a New Preference-Based Quality of Life Measure with Older People Receiving Aged Care Services at Home. I present Dr. Jenny Cleland. Joyce Haddad. By thesis entitled Communicating for Impact, Tailoring Nutrition Messages to Influence Dietary Behavior, I present Dr. Joyce Haddad. Chad Yisi Angyan. By thesis, entitled Pre-Frailty and Frailty in Hospitalized Older Adults, Prevalence, Identification, and Development of a Self-Managed Exercise and Nutrition Program, I present Dr. Chad Yisi Angyan. Christopher Allen Muldoon. By thesis entitled The Emotions Experienced by Guide Dog Owners in the Application, Training and Working of Their Guide Dogs, I present in all his wonderful kilt, Dr. Christopher Allen Muldoon. Morgan Pankhurst. By thesis entitled Measuring Consumer Food Service Satisfaction in Residential Aged Care Homes, I present Dr. Morgan Pankhurst. Jasmine Marie Peterson. By thesis entitled Promoting Physical Activity, The Role of Commercial Physical Activity Apps and Online Social Networking, I present Dr. Jasmine Peterson. Jennifer Jane Phillips. By thesis entitled Fluid Distribution and Tissue Resistance, Response to Intermittent Pneumatic Compression in People with and Without primary lymphedema. I present Dr. Jane Phillips. And our last awardee of today's event is Paul Anthony Tate. By thesis entitled Pharmaceutical Care of the Dying, I present Dr. Paul Anthony Tate. Flinders University offers its warmest congratulations and good wishes to our graduates, and I invite you all to share your appreciation for their achievements by applauding their efforts. As alumni, you have the power to change the world. Don't just take it from us. Your peers are living proof of the power of a Flinders degree and the benefits of staying connected.
Being in touch with the Flinders Alumni Network really does open doors for you on both a professional and personal level.
Getting your foot in the door, or any kind of door of opportunities. It's like if you want to change careers, or if you need some mentoring, any kind of advice.
I get the opportunity to come back sometimes and talk to the students who are currently studying.
It is super inspiring to get those updates all the time from the alumni network.
It allowed me to say what could be possible looking forward.
I've sort of assisted with some of the outreach activities that have been conducted at Flinders, and I can see the richness that is provided by some of those courses.
I haven't gone this far, if I haven't got the support from Flinders Alumni Network.
I've been kind of out of touch, and this is one way to keep in touch.
Flinders approached me about talking to current students, just to perhaps give them some insight into what life might be like as a graduate. It's often given me time just to reflect on where I am and where I came from.
I think studying at Flinders really prepares you for the next stage of life, whatever you might choose. But I think we're all on a lifelong journey of discovery and learning. And I think what Flinders does well is teaches us how to learn and study. So whatever you take from you today will be useful moving forward in whatever direction you choose.
Congratulations to the graduating class.
You finished your education and now you're ready for the next step.
It's great to virtually see you here.
It's a time to really take chances.
So much hard work, and you've been through a very challenging time.
Celebrate your achievements, like you've got a university degree. It's crazy.
Congratulations to all those students graduating today. I graduated in 2004, and I never would have imagined that my studies would have opened the doors that it has for me.
Be fearless.
Representing the Vice-Chancellor, Professor Colin Stirling, this afternoon is our Deputy Vice-Chancellor Students, Professor Romy Lawson. Professor Lawson joined Flinders University in January this year, and she has a focus on student success and ensuring that our students have an absolutely exceptional learning experience. To close this afternoon's formal proceedings, I invite Professor Romy Lawson to the lectern.
Chancellor, graduates, guests, colleagues. Graduations are always a special event in the university calendar, as it's when we get to celebrate. We get to celebrate what we're all about as a university, and that's student success. So it's with absolute pleasure and delight that I get to be here with you today to congratulate you all on your achievement. Now, graduates, take a deep breath. Look around, take in the moment and smile. You did it. And I don't mean walking across the stage without tripping up. I mean you've worked hard, you remained dedicated over the last few years to experience this day, the day when you graduate with the Flinders University degree. You should all be exceptionally proud. You are a university graduate. Now, friends and family of our graduates, take a deep breath, look around, take in the moment, and smile, because you made it too. I imagine you're feeling immensely proud of the people you're here today to support. While the individuals in front of you are those who've received their degrees today, I think that some praise should be reserved for you, their support networks. I have little doubt that you've been providing the encouragement to our students that they needed to get through their studies, sharing in their challenges and celebrating their triumphs. I am sure, like all of us at Flinders University, you have watched in awe as these remarkable and intrepid individuals have faced down the toughest of circumstances and overcome them. I would like to extend my thanks on behalf of Flinders University for your support and the role you've played in their success. Now, if I can ask for the house lights to come up for a moment, and if we can ask for our graduates to stand up and turn to face your friends and family, putting your parchments down as you do it. It is your chance to publicly thank your friends and family. So please take this opportunity to express that thanks by giving them a rousing round of applause, and your cheering and whooping is accepted. Thank you. You can be seated. Make sure you pick up your parchment before you sit down. Splendid. Now, Flinders staff, take a deep breath, look around and take in the moment and smile, because you made it happen. I'm sure you'll all agree I'm joined on stage by some of those wonderful staff, both academic and professional, who've guided you on your educational journey. These individuals represent a much larger group of teachers, mentors, and support staff who've helped and inspired you. Over the last couple of years, they've coped with redesigning their teaching and support services, adapting and overcoming challenges to ensure you could still progress with your studies. Their dedication has been remarkable, and I invite you now to show your appreciation with a round of applause. What does it mean to be a graduate? For years, a university degree has served as evidence of continued hard work and dedication, proof that you can put your mind to something and achieve it. But now, especially given the last few years of upheaval and unprecedented times, a university degree shows something more. It says that you are graced with a courageous spirit. When the going got tough, and at times it got extremely tough, you displayed a courage and determination that showed us all that you will do great things. You've gained the specialist skills of your discipline, but more than that, you've developed a lifelong ability to think critically, and this ability will continue to change and expand over your lifetime. Now, the award of a university degree carries many privileges, but like all privileges, it also carries responsibilities. As graduates of Flinders University, I ask you to strive to set high goals and continue the hard work, to keep asking the right questions to find the answers that you need, to use what you've learnt for your own betterment, but also for the good of the community. So today you're a university graduate, but tomorrow your next adventure begins. And when I was preparing this speech, I reflected on some of the things that have helped me in my professional career. And as such, I wanted to share with you my five top tips. So tip number one, don't be afraid to think differently and to question why. Tip number two, it's okay to say no in your professional life. Find and follow your moral compass. Number three, it's okay to fail, but it's not okay not to learn from any failures. Number four, don't always expect perfection. Manage your creative expectations. The world won't end if the frozen pizza doesn't look as good as the picture on the box, as long as it tastes like pizza. And the last one, don't wait for everything to be in place before you do something. Think big, start small, and start now. Because once you start, then you will begin learning. Now, it's our hope that you look back on your university days with fondness, that when you think of your time at Flinders, you remember them as rich and rewarding. And I hope you remember the people that made your time with us what it was, the lifelong friends that will be by your side long after you leave us, the fellow students who were there beside you learning and growing, and the Flinders staff who shaped your experience to be uniquely yours. Remember that our doors will always be open to you. For some of you, we're saying farewell. Others are transitioning into new pathways of learning with us at Flinders. To all of you, I hope you keep us updated on your journeys, invite us to celebrate in your achievements, and share in your Flinders memories. So, on behalf of Flinders University, I congratulate all of you on your excellent academic achievements, and I wish you every success in the future.
Thank you, Professor Lawson, for those inspiring words. In concluding formalities, I invite you to stand for the academic procession as our dignitaries lead our newest graduates from the hall and onto their new path of achievement. Thank you.